sorry, guys. It's 3 o'clock, and I promise this. I silence. Boy, I.
Leave that alone. Leave that alone.
And he didn't like that?
I didn't exactly like it, but I forgot the line.
Why did he pick on Richie and no one else?
I don't know.
You're all right. I got here in time.
What is it, Lyle?
The men, they're rioting in cell block 3. Bert Lancaster is holding you and Cronin hostage.
Lyle.
I missed the blinds. The men, they're rioting in cell block 3. Bert Lancaster is holding you and Cronin hostage.
Lyle.
Walton, they're going to kill him if they don't get your demands. And I blew that.
Go back to the window.
Damn it.
Stay where you are. All right, do the window, bit. Get shot. Go. Lyle.
They're going to kill him.
Keep going. Okay. Help. And he knows if he does hit her back, that we're going to punish her. Tom.
Danny Thomas, 166, PG1, take one.
Don't worry, if you don't get it right, we'll take it again and again, and we'll beat you for a while. Come over here. And it's got 30% more protein per spoonful than any other cereal, and I gotta say it again, because I blobbed it.
Well, if you're gonna get so dramatic about it, I'll go move in with all the neighbors.
You will go do what?
This week. All right,
come
on. If I ever hear you complain, young man, you'll really get it from me. You're a pretty lucky kid to have your own room.
Well, if you're going to be so dramatic, I'll
I'm marking this down. It's all going in the report.
You got to sit down.
Can I ask you something?
Hey, don't ask me anything. You're a pain in the ass. Get out of here. Go to some other show. I'm fed up to here with you.
Do that again.
You're a little Jude Rolfe. I've had it with you. 4 days. This isn't going with the wind. We're standing here. You're doing 40 minutes. It's costing me $8 million.
$7 million?
In between fireman's carriage. Now, as soon as I touch the man, he locks in on me.
What I want to know is, in a fireman's hurry, how we can get both hands on the cheeks. That's what I'm trying to figure out.
I swear, I'm not kidding around. Come on.
Come on.
This is the end of Dorothy and Barbara.
I'll get the ring Friday.
Could we meet early tomorrow and look for furniture?
Oh, God.
Yes, sir.
Camera's on. Look at it.
Well, okay. Well, don't scare me. Boo!
How do I get?
Go ahead.
Come rolling.
Three, two, three. Now watch your hand.
Okay. Come on, guys.
All right. Action.
All right, now we're going to start out at daylight. That'll give you a 4-hour start and enough time to circle the flats and get across the plateau.
Fine, we'll be there.
Good. We'll see you.
Go.
I want to take a look at that arm.
Action.
Son of a bitch.
You got somebody particular in mind?
Nope. Oh, I just... I mean, it'd be nice if somebody that needed it wanted.
Well, good. I guess I'm just getting a little gun-shy.
I wouldn't try to influence you, are you kidding?
Thanks.
Now, the Widow Cumberland.
I knew it.
I said the Widow Cumberland.
Okay, I know at least man, including Wayne, whatever her name is. God damn it. What in the cunt's name?
I remember. You just better pray, motherfucker.
Looking over at the cabin door. Dan, look at the cabin door.
Oh, shit.
The kids are coming out, babe. Just take a quick peek. All right, Sam.
I can't turn my...
All right,
I...
It wouldn't be honest not to tell you, but the horse is taking a leap.
She pulled down her pants and did some obscene things to her.
I'll arrange for full cooperation from British intelligence. Goodbye.
Cut.
Any dynamite yet?
Yeah, Rick, I'm on whatever that street is.
I'll tell Susie to call everybody and have... I don't know why that fucking line is doing that.
All right, here we go. All right, see you.
Goodbye.
Yeah.
Walt?
Yeah.
She gives great hair.
All right. Got it. Fine.
Okay, we've got to move and we've got to take all this stuff with us. Now, how the hell are we going to do that?
What's that? Breaking the rules of living, learning how to live. This something.
Rule. Civilized assholes, I think, but we got to make that work for us, so that we stay on our toes, so we stay alert. And any time we're alert, we're alert.
Okay, I'll admit it was partially my blame, but I ain't taking the full rap.
Well, you shouldn't. I mean, you know, you're not the only let's go back and, what about him?
Hey, it takes two to tango.
What are you talking about?
What do you mean, what am I talking about? You know what I'm talking about. Shithead.
Well, we had it going. Don't overlap him.
But I ain't taking the full rap.
Well, you shouldn't. You're not the only... Let's stop.
Yeah, here you go.
He just, I'll just stick it in his...
Magnum! I think I got the magnums in there. Listen, they made me... I'll shoot the living shit out of you!
One of these babies, I'm going to knock you in the middle of next week. I'll slap the shit out of him and then slap him for shit.
You know, Freddy, it's been a long 16 weeks, but... I just want you to know, even though I've been a little tough on you, I really do like you.
Oh, go fuck yourself, Charlie!
Hey! Hey, you green son of a bitch! I've been putting up with you, I've been showing you mercy!
You're nothing but an old faggot!
One stinking night you caught me with my cousin Arson and you got the guts to call me a faggot!
Yeah, well, you wanted me since the start of the series!
Well, now that it's all out in the open, we might as well have a ball.
How about two?
It's the Soupy Sale Show, starring Soupy Sale.
And you do that, I love you, give me a kiss.
Be careful.
That's all right.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Anyway, well, all I know is the music was playing, and, Yes, and right now, let's have a couple of commercials.
Oh, Brett, I am a wreck.
Why are you so excited?
Well, I've got my interview today.
Where did I leave my eyelashes? You'll feel a lot cooler if you just use some Johnson's Daughter, baby.
Why did I cut my hair? I look like a squirrel. Who am I?
I have no idea, but you'll feel a lot better if you just use some baby powder.
If it's going to be one of those days when you need to keep a little cooler, a little drier, and a lot more comfortable, use pure Johnson's baby powder.
Oh, my baby! Oh, boy, do I need that!
Pardon me, sir. Are you a nudist?
No, I'm a fig tree waiting for a bus that went bad.
Get out of here. Oh, then you are a nudist.
Yes, I'm a nudist. Brilliant. You must be a regular rocket scientist.
Tell me, how does one become a nudist?
Well, it helps if you take your clothes off first.
Yeah. Well, let me ask you this, sir. How long have you been a nudist?
Since my wife divorced me in California. When your wife gets everything, you screwed up the lines. Get the hell out of here.
Who screwed up the lines?
My lines were perfect.
Because I feel you're standing right on top of me and I'm in the nude.
Play it. Why can't you play it? Play it like you're in the nude. And you're embarrassed. Can't you play it? You've only got one dimension to you. Play it.
All right, I'll dimension you.
I'll make it such a dimension your wife will go, my God, it's an orangutan.
Get the colored guy off the set. Unless there's any cleaning to be done.
What is it, old man? Are you looking for men who...
Maybe just shut up, George.
Yeah.
Don't sing and read the lines.
Here we go.
Why don't you come with a candle on your ass?
All right.
What do you have to do, the phony walk? Walk over there.
Play a while.
Sit there and do your job. What do you have to do, the phony walk? Just stay in character. I'll tell you what. You walk in and I'll sit. 8 to 5, we get it done that way.
Get over there.
Old Jew with polio.
What is it, old man? Are you looking for men who can march for days without food or water?
Yes.
And who can shoot and stab and kill and murder and hurt?
Yes, we are.
I just wanted to know because I screwed it up. Let's do it.
I pay you $24 on a handful of beads.
Hey, now, wait a minute. You're out of line.
Seem fair to me. You people buy entire island of Manhattan for same price.
Ah, it was a lousy deal, Chief. In 100 years, they won't get a nickel for the place.
No, white man very smart about real estate. Remember when you first come here? This once entire Kaui territory. Then you make treaty, we divide land. Holy Jesus Christ.
Sergeant Rourke, Corporal Lake, I'm reporting, sir.
Oh, at ease, man, at ease. I've, called you in because I'd like to discuss this business of this.
Hey, oh, are you all right,
sir? Yes, I'm fine. I'm fine. I have to get that loose board fixed.
Oh.
I'll get Private Duffy on it this afternoon, sir.
Yes, yeah, you do that.
Thank you. Thank you.
You were saying, sir.
Kenny.
Just a little higher, Duffy. We want to make sure those horns are not at pants level.
I know what you mean, sir.
Sergeant O'Rourke, Corporal Agard reporting, sir.
Eddie's. You can just put those down, Duffy.
Yes, sir.
Now, it has come to my attention that you men are not talking to each other. Now, what seems to be the problem?
Well, who'd tell you a thing like that, sir?
I told the captain.
You've got a loud bugle and a mouth to match.
You can't talk to me like that, Agar.
He can talk to you any way he wants.
No, no, wait a minute, man.
The minute you hear something, you go running right to the captain.
Well, I just think it's stupid for two friends not to be talking.
Who are you calling stupid?
Well, I'll tell you one thing. I may be stupid, but I'm smart enough never to talk to you again.
Yes, and that goes for me, too.
Now, gentlemen, gentlemen, listen. We can't have non-commissioned officers not talking to each other and not talking to the men under them.
Now, look, Agar, no soldier ever has a good enough reason not to talk to his buddy.
Captain Parmenter.
Yes, Corporal.
Would you tell Private Duffy that I just found a good reason never to speak to him again?
I'm still talking to you, Duffy.
Well, I ain't talking to no man who comes down to the captain over a little thing like this.
It's not such a little thing, either.
Good morning, Elroy.
Good morning, sir. Sure, they've arrived. And by gig. They're afraid to even get on PT-13.
I tell you, Elroy, this is my finest hour.
Oh, yeah.
Is the radio message ready? We've got to work fast before McHale gets back. Okay, you are. Now, down outside door, Elroy.
Including your heads of chocolate. I found out.
Oh, don't see that, baby, huh?
Well, if you want my opinion.
I don't want your opinion, you horse's ass. Well, McHale, you and I both know that you collect the biggest bunch of shit.
We're gathered here to put these two together. And some other stuff.
That was a good year for that ship, wasn't it?
Well, we better get back to the airstrip. It's time to greet the mothers of the BP-73.
Oh, those mothers.
The fly's open.
Ow!
Right now?
Boca Raton.
Here's Johnny.
And here we are sitting here doing
this while
you guys are. No, we're delighted to have your expanded schedule on the Tonight Show, and we look forward to continued increasing success with the Vic Chemical Company. And, Ed,
yes.
I heard some news today that I found rather fascinating. I understand that the Vicks people have come up with a new toiletry product that they're pretty excited about. I haven't heard much about it. What is it?
It's called Dismiss.
Dismiss?
Yes.
Huh? What is that?
It's a feminine hygiene product.
Holy crap. You're putting me on.
No, Dismiss. It'll be advertised on our show.
How about Vegigo?
That's not a bad name for it. Along with another line.
How about Cuntaway?
Someone else has that.
Ah.
Sterling Drugs.
How about Fuck Off?
Possibly.
Yes, I like that.
I like Formula 44, NyQuil, Sinex, Victor's and Labor's, all the other fine products, along with Dismiss.
Fuck Off would be a bummer. Is that going to be a live commercial?
I was wondering if you'd like to demonstrate.
I certainly would. The strawberries and lemons, I think. Pass a fruit stand, you get a horny now. Good sales. Dismiss.
Anyway, welcome
Jesus
back again, Vic.
Christ. So embarrassed to do this.
Dismiss.
Oh. So embarrassed.